In the previous video, we discussed the basics of how brake systems work. Now we are going to take a look at some calculations. In this first example, a driver applies 10 pounds of force to this brake pedal. We want to find the force on the rod of this master cylinder. In the picture, we see the distance from the foot to the fulcrum is 10 inches, and the distance from the rod of the master cylinder to the fulcrum is 2 inches. In order to find the force on the rod, we need to find what the mechanical advantage of the brake pedal is. Then, we can use some formulas from Unit 5 to find the output force. First, mechanical advantage is the distance from the foot to the fulcrum divided by the distance from the rod to the fulcrum. So we can take 10 inches and divide by 2 inches. This gives us a mechanical advantage of 5. Now, we can look in an equation circle that we saw way back in Unit 5, where we have output force on top, and input force and mechanical advantage both on the bottom. Covering up output force, we are left with input force multiplied by mechanical advantage. The input force is the force applied by the driver's foot, which is 10 pounds, and the mechanical advantage we just found to be 5. Multiplying, we see the output force on the rod of the master cylinder is 50 pounds. Let's take a look at another example. A driver applies 30 pounds of force to the brake pedal in this system. First, we want to find what force is applied to the piston in the master cylinder. Remember, the piston in the master cylinder will be the output force. We are looking at the same brake pedal as in the previous example, and it has a mechanical advantage of 5. Looking at the force and mechanical advantage equation circle, we see that the output force is the force applied to the master cylinder piston, and that's equal to the input force multiplied by the mechanical advantage. The input force is 30 pounds, and the mechanical advantage is 5. Multiplying, we see that the output force at the master cylinder piston is 150 pounds. Continuing to the next part, the master cylinder uses a 1-inch diameter piston. What pressure is created in the master cylinder? To find the pressure, we have to take the force divided by the area. However, in this problem, we aren't specifically given the area. We have to solve for the area using the diameter. The area of a circle, or in this case, the piston, is equal to pi multiplied by the diameter squared divided by 4. Substituting in the diameter of 1 inch, we see that the area of the piston is 0.785 square inches. Now, we can find the pressure by taking the force of 150 pounds and dividing it by the area of 0.785 square inches. This gives us a pressure generated in the master cylinder of 191 pounds per square inch. Now, we know the front wheel caliper has a piston diameter of 2.20 inches. We want to find the force that is exerted by the caliper. Looking at the equation circle, we know that force is equal to pressure multiplied by area. Just like in the last part, we aren't specifically given the area, so we have to find the area of the front wheel caliper piston. Again, area is equal to pi multiplied by the diameter squared divided by 4. Substituting in 2.20 inches for the diameter, we see the area of the piston is 3.799 square inches. Now we can find the force by taking the pressure of 191 psi from the previous part and multiplying by 3.799 square inches. Remember, we can use the same pressure as the previous part because pressure in any hydraulic system remains constant throughout the system. This gives us a force of 726 pounds. Last, we want to find how much force is produced by a 1.30 inch diameter rear wheel cylinder. Again, since we are finding force, we can use the equation circle to see that force is equal to the pressure multiplied by the area. Just like the last two parts, we need to calculate the area in order to find the force. Area is pi multiplied by the diameter squared divided by 4, so substituting in 1.3 inches as our diameter, we end up with an area of 1.327 square inches. Now, we can take the pressure from the system of 191 psi found in Part B and multiply that by the area of 1.327 square inches to see what the force that produced by a 1.3 inch diameter rear wheel cylinder will be 253 pounds. One last thing that I want to mention, since the wheel cylinders are smaller than the caliper pistons, the force they create is less. This concludes our discussion of hydraulic systems.